Hi everyone, I'm Brad Bull, and let's look at the problem at hand. We have a stick with uniform mass m lying inside of a frictionless well. The stick makes an angle of theta with the well, with the horizontal. And the question asks to solve for all the forces acting on the stick. So let's draw a free body diagram. This is the stick. We have a force of mg from the weight of the stick. Oh, also, the length of this stick is L. L, I'll just write that there. There's a normal force from the right wall. Let's call it F sub 2. Because the normal force from the left wall, I'm going to call F sub 1. Here, I'll draw it a little bigger. F sub 1. And then we have a normal force from the ground coming up. Call it F sub G. Ah, that's a bad G, sorry. F sub G. So notice Mg is a known force. And we know its quantity since M is given, and so is G. But F2, Fg, and F1, I made up those forces just now. Or not made up, but I don't know the quantities or the values of those forces yet. So since we have three unknowns, I think we'll want to have three equations. However many unknowns you have, you're going to want that many equations. So first, what I want to do is use Newton's second law, F equals ma, for the y direction. So, right, Newton's second law in the y direction. If upward force is positive, then downward force is negative. So we have F sub g, the normal force from the ground, minus mg equals zero. So then F sub g, the normal force from the ground, is just equal to mg. We've already solved for one force. Now let's do Newton's second law for the forces in the x direction. We have F equals ma. This should equal zero because the stick is not moving within the well. Let rightward force be positive quantities. So F sub 1 is going right, minus F sub 2 equals 0. So then we just have F sub 1 equals F sub 2. So that means if we solve for one of these, we'll have solved for the other one. We have two equations. Now we need one more. We've already done forces now, so let's examine torques. I think what I want to do is examine the torques about this point, because there are two unknowns at this point, and these two forces produce zero torque about this point. So we gets rid of two unknowns. So then by examining torques about this left end, I can solve for F sub 2, since the only forces causing torques are F sub 2 and mg. So let me write that out. The net torque will equal I times alpha, and there's no alpha since there's no angular acceleration, since it's not moving. The stick isn't moving, so zero. So first, if we denote, let's say, counterclockwise motion to be positive, then we'll say the torque caused by this mg will make the stick go in a clockwise direction. So negative mg force times lever arm. The lever arm will be L over 2 time, or will be this distance essentially, which is L over 2, since this whole thing is L over 2 times adjacent over hypotenuse cosine theta. The quantity L over 2 cosine theta plus this F sub 2 causes the causes a counterclockwise direction. So plus F sub 2 times the lever arm, which is essentially this distance right here, the perpendicular distance from the force, which is L times sine theta, opposite over hypotenuse. So L times sine theta, this all equals zero. Now let me rewrite this. I'm gonna move this negative quantity to the right, so everything's just positive. Now, here, let me rewrite this since it's not very straight. All right, now I can solve for F sub 2 by dividing both sides by L sine theta. Now this quantity just equals, the L's go away. So we have 1/2 cosine theta right here. I'm gonna move this 1/2. I'm gonna just say that since it's the same thing. Now we have mg times cosine theta over 2 sine theta. I'll say mg over 2. This cosine theta can technically be rewritten as this, since this cosine theta would go up like that. So really, F sub 2 equals this in its simplest form. So F sub 2 equals this. So then F sub 1 also does equal this. And we solved for F sub 1, F sub 2, and F sub g, which is the normal force caused by the ground. And there you have it.